In today's video, we're going to go over how to convert a Cisco 3700 series lightweight access point to autonomous using image recovery. First, we have to install TFTP server software. There's a shareware TFTP utility that is recommended by Cisco. I'll have a link for this in the description below. I already have this downloaded, so I will proceed to installing it. Be sure to allow Windows Firewall on the public network for this, otherwise the access point won't be able to get through to the image. The next thing we have to do is configure our network adapter, and we have to assign it a static IP address of 10.0.0.2, and then our subnet mask of 255.255.255.224. Leave the rest of the fields blank and click OK. And we confirm that that is properly set. The next thing we have to do is set up a terminal emulator on the computer so that we can communicate with the access point. In this case, we are using PuTTY with my server's built-in serial port. You can determine the correct port number in Device Manager. Our next step will be renaming the tar file to a .default file. I'm just going to make a copy of it this way, I don't modify the original. We'll remove the ending as shown and put tar.default. And we do confirm that we want to change it. I'm going to copy this file and put it into the directory of which TFTPD64 is installed. You can choose another location if you desire. We're now going to go to our access point. We're going to start with connecting the serial cable to the console port. And we're going to hold down the mode button while we plug in our Ethernet cable. In my case, it is receiving power through the Ethernet cable. And once the access point has a solid red color, we can release the mode button. It is now loading the image. The access point has now finished downloading the file, so it's going to reboot with the new image. That's all there is to it. Thanks for watching.